pour me another one. Okay, whatever.
Yo.
The
fuck?
Why you pressed about me fucking on him?
Bitch, what?
Hit up at I am Dante.
The most fire fucking review on YouTube. Shouts out to I am Dante.
Okay.
Young sad Yori, I ain't got shit but money. Yeah. Post pics on Instagram that might steal your honey. Yeah. So hot I give the sun a run for his money. But I'm chilling like I'm Ice Cube, cold nose runny.
Oh my gosh, bro. I thought I was gonna have to wait 2 weeks, bro, to talk to you ever again in my life. But a miracle did happen. Miracles do happen. Miracles do happen. You're up there, guy. You're up there, big guy, huh? Oh my gosh, if y'all don't know what's going on, if y'all don't know what happened, I had 2 strikes, okay? And if you wanna know how I had 2 strikes, why I had 2 strikes, just check out the other video that I had on it, all right? Cause I talk about everything in there. And if you're a YouTuber, you might wanna check it out as well. Cause I tell you how you might wanna avoid, or how you might be able to avoid ever having to deal with that stuff again. All right, period, all right? Juice World's new album, it's called Goodbye and Good Riddance. And I told y'all when I first heard him, I really liked his music. And then when I just heard that new song with that girl that he was like fiending over, who didn't even look that good in the music video, who I knew I was an actor, so I'm sure she's beautiful in real life. When I heard that, after I heard that, I was like, yeah, I want to hear his full, like anything that he dropped, like if he drops an album, I want to hear that. I want to hear the full thing. So he dropped an album. He dropped an album yesterday, or was it yesterday? I think it was yesterday. It dropped yesterday, and y'all were telling me about it. Even though I was on a 2-week ban, even though I said this on Twitter and I said this on Instagram, niggas was still messaging me like, hey bro, I know you're on a 2-week ban, but you might want to check this out, bro. And what I was gonna do, what I was really thinking about doing was, you know, recording all the videos that were coming out and anything that would have dropped. And then as soon as that ban was up, I was just gonna drop like 15 videos at once or something like that. Like do a video a day and then just drop like 14 videos the day that I get out. Get out, first day out, B. I'm about to drop a song. I'm about to drop a song, son. Goodbye, Good Riddance. This man is still, you know, angry about whoever it is this girl is. He's clearly talking to some girl. And this, his rise to his rise to stardom has, you know, not changed the way he thought. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into this. This is 40 minutes long, so let's go ahead. Great. Okay, let me get my headphones, which are right here. I'm really gonna get new headphones, y'all. I'm really gonna get new headphones. I know. Alright, so, yeah, I was listening to this song.
You can disappear, disrespect the next game.
Oh, yeah.
Chop a goal, crop, cut off.
Don't care, that pussy got some mileage, mileage.
But okay, Goodbye, Good Riddance. Intro, all girls are the same. Loose. Yo, y'all was getting on me, because when I had reacted to the song, let's just get to this.
I told you to stop fucking calling me. I fucking hate you.
No, for real. Like,
stop fucking calling me. I don't want to hear from you no more.
Damn, bruh. I hope these aren't actual messages and this is just like the, you know, an actor. But honestly, bro, I want to know what happened. Like, I want to feel for you. But it's like the way she talking, my guy, were you in the wrong? Was she in the wrong? I don't think she would be snapping like that if she was in the wrong, but what happened, bruh? Hopefully this album explains, because it seemed like you did something and she just don't want to talk to you no more, even though you're trying to get her to like realize something, but
I said I hate you! Stop calling me!
Because I'm done.
Nigga, you ain't do shit for me. I promise you.
Talk all this big shit. Like, you gonna be something. You're not gonna be shit. I promise you.
You gonna be stuck where the fuck you're at. And you gonna be wishing that you knew me.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Like I said, I don't know what happened, who's in the wrong, who did what. But this man is heartbroken. And I'm pretty sure that stuck with him when she said that. When she said, You're gonna be right here where you are. You're not gonna be anywhere. We've all been told that. Well, anybody that's chasing a dream has all been told, bro, you're not gonna make it anywhere. You're gonna be stuck doing exactly what I'm doing. You're gonna stay in the same job, bro. You're not gonna go anywhere. You're not gonna do nothing. So it's like when you do make it, you're gonna feel like, bro, every song on this album is gonna be about you, bitch. Oh my gosh. All right, so. I've already heard this song. This is the first song I've actually heard from him. If you want to see my reaction to that, just type in I'm Dante. All girls are the same reaction. You can go ahead and check that out. Now, some people that still don't get it, okay? I just experienced two strikes, okay? But those were community guideline strikes. The reason why I edit so much on my music reactions is to make it transformative. I put my opinion out there. I talk about the song more than me just listening, you just listening to the song. You should be coming here to hear what I have to say and how I react to certain parts of the song. You shouldn't be here trying to listen to the full album or a full song. That's what the link in the description is for, and that's where you go check that out. There's gonna be a lot of cuts, like I have been doing in all my album reactions, which I actually made a playlist for now, because I'm cool like that. So yes, and also I skip songs that I've already heard because there's no point in me, you know, listening to the same song when I've already heard it. It's not a genuine reaction. I've already heard the song, so people can stop complaining about that, because it's like in every album reaction or in any music video reaction, I got people saying, bro, I love you, Dante, but ease up on the cutting out. Like, bitch, you can work, if you got a channel, you go on your channel, you do an album reaction the way you want to do it, okay? Play the full album if you want to. But I know I figured out a way how I cannot get in trouble for it, making it transformative and putting in my discussion. Plus, I like to talk a lot. You know, I got a big mouth, all right? The next song is Lucid Dreams, and I've already reacted to this too. I'm Dante, Lucid Dreams. You can go ahead and check that out. Now, what I was saying at the beginning was, y'all was getting on me, because I accidentally said liquid dreams. I don't know. Sometimes I am stupid and I read the words wrong or pronounce the words wrong. But it's lucid dreams, not liquid dreams. But I've already heard that. You know, you already know what to do. I'm Dante, liquid dreams. All right, next one. Let's get it. Lean With Me. Let's go.
Drugs got me sweating, but the room getting colder. Looking at the devil and the angel on my shoulder. Laying with me. Pop with me. Get high with me if you rock with me.
I don't get high.
Smoke with me.
No.
Drink with me. Fucked up liver with some bad kidneys.
Laying with me. I cannot ride with that, man. I know you're hurt, okay? But you are not about to get me to do something that I don't want to. That's called peer pressure, and I don't care how popular you are, Mr. Juice WRLD. I will not tolerate it. I will not have it.
Told her if I die, I'ma die young. Every day I've been getting fucked up. Shorty tell me I should really sober up. Fuck one dose, I need two pills.
Okay, this is the time where we need to start going to these artists and talk to them. We can't just be sitting here singing these songs at shows. This man is really hurt, and he's talking about, fuck, taking one pill, pop two of them, bruh. I'm trying to pass the buck. Like, Juice, Mr. Juice, you got the juice now. You need to relax, okay? I don't know what happened in this relationship with this girl that said some messed up stuff. I don't know if you had a part to play in it, okay? I can't just assume that you're all Mr. Innocence, but right, it is not worth just killing yourself over some girl, all right? I know she probably meant the world to you, but you gotta cut it out, all right? And I'm not just specifically talking to him. I'm voicing it to anybody that feels like they can relate to him, all right?
Ring, ring, plug, hit my phone, perfect time, man. I know I'm not right, but I'm not wrong.
Okay.
No, I'm not wrong.
Hold on.
Girl, you hate it when I'm too high, but that's where I belong, where I belong.
Okay, so he admits, he said, I know that I'm not right, but I'm also not wrong. And I understand that argument, okay? You cannot be right sometimes. But also, you cannot be wrong at the same time. But, bro, you said she hates it when you're high, but that's where you belong. Is this where this argument is stemming from? That you just keep getting high, and she's trying to tell you, bro, you need to cut that out. That's not good for you. And you're probably being too stingy, like, leave me the hell alone. This is my life. Da da da. I mean, that part, if that's one of the many arguments y'all had, I agree with the girl in this situation, bro. Stop doing all these drugs, bro. She trying to help you, bro. Cut it out.
Crash the Mustang, no sailing. Yeah, I love peace. Yeah, I love lean. I laugh when they ask if my piss clean. If I overdose, bae, are you gon' drop with me? Too high, reach a new high. Take the shrooms and the pills at the same time.
Oh my gosh, somebody talk to this man. Like, seriously, like, niggas is just gonna be singing this song like, yo, Juice WRLD's lit, bro, he's up next. No, this nigga's gonna be dead before he can even do his next album. I really like this man's music. And I feel like I said before, the best art comes from pain. But, oh my gosh. I hate to encourage this, but this music is so good. That's the thing that was going on with Eminem. Eminem was making some dope, crazy-ass music when this nigga was high. But, I mean, he still makes dope music, but y'all know what I'm talking about, alright? Y'all know what I'm talking about. And I don't want it to be the same for Juice WRLD. I don't want his best art to be while he's all fucked up off these drugs, man. Like, I hope this goodbye and good riddance is for, like, this girl. Like, the girl. And he's not talking about himself. Because the way he's talking, the way I'm getting from this song, is like, this man plans on killing himself after just releasing this album. Alright, that was Lane With Me. The next one is called I'm Still.
Bitch, I'm still flexing with my heart broken. Got my heart open, I'm not hiding. And I roll my dosage, I'm getting higher.
He's still talking about getting high. But he like, bitch, I'm still turning up. Even with you hurting me, I'm still doing me. What up? Jeez, I need to know more of this, like, this story between them two.
I still love my pills. I feel in love with your face off the shrooms.
I don't know what it is, but that, like, he did that in Lucid Dreams, and I don't know what it is, but it seems like he's just, like, he's really into the song. Like, I don't know what it is, but I be getting, the hairs on my arms be standing up. I get chills, bro. It's lit.
Elephant all in the room.
Yeah.
She buried me in a tomb.
Huh?
I'm feeling overconsumed.
Huh?
When I'm alone in the room.
What?
I'ma blame that on the shrooms.
Stop it, man. You...
Don't know what to do.
You don't gotta do drugs, bruh. You don't.
Lost my heart, don't got shit to lose.
And he just let that one right out too. He said, broke my heart, or did he say lost my heart, don't got shit to lose? Probably said, hold on.
Lost my heart, don't got shit to lose.
Lost my heart, don't got shit to lose. You mean to tell me this breakup was so devastating that he's just like, I don't got nothing else to lose, bruh. I don't even care anymore, bruh. I am popping pills, I am drinking lean, I am eating shrooms, I am doing all of this stuff. Forget my kidney, forget my liver. I also smoke cigarettes. Ah, gosh. I feel so bad for him. I feel so bad for him, but it's like, I don't even know what's going on, bruh. I don't know whose side. I don't even know. Like, he said he was wrong. He said he was wrong, but, you know. Or he said he know he's not right, but he knows he's not wrong as well. He is pouring his soul out on these tracks, bruh. Oh my gosh. The next one is called Betrayal. Betrayal. It's a skit. Nice little calm, a little skit. I need this little break from all these drugs that he's popping, bruh. He's making me feel like I'm just, oh my gosh.
Oh my God. I know this ain't you calling me again. Yeah, it's him.
Jeez.
You found out about who? Yeah, I bet you did found out about me and who.
Did this bitch cheat on you, Juice WRLD? Did this trifling bitch cheat on you, Juice WRLD? Oh, now I understand. Now I understand it all. Now I understand it all.
Yeah, I fuck with him.
Oh!
I fuck with him, for real.
Oh!
Oh, you mad now?
Oh, you bit. What?
Bro, pour me another one. Okay, whatever.
Yo!
I'll talk to you later, okay?
The fuck?
Why you pressed about me fucking on him?
Bitch, what? Oh my god. Now I understand. Okay. I got a little bit more context to the story at hand. This bitch, this thought, is a freaking cheater? Bro. And then you got the nerve to call her, and then she's like, yeah. Yeah, I f with the nigga so, like, you add down. Like, what? Bruh. No wonder why this man is, like, feeling how he is, but, like, this. Okay, I kind of understand where it's coming from, but I don't know. Like, these drugs, all these drugs that this man's doing now, you gotta cut that out. Like, you just gotta stop that. That's not gonna help the situation one bit. It may numb the pain, but it's like, bruh, so does jogging, bruh. So does taking a shower, bro. Like, you don't need to do this. You don't need to do all these pills. The next one is called candles. Oh my gosh, that is infuriating. Cause she's just like chilling with her girls and they're like, oh, you mad now? Like, yeah, I fuck with him more than you know. I'll be like, bitch, you're gonna do this to me, bitch. You're gonna do this to me. I'm gonna be the greatest beeper. Oh my god. Let's check out this next song, bruh. Candles.
I don't know if it's because my heart hurts or if I'm insecure. I'm not sure. You're not her. My last girl had me so fucked up, it was a blacked out blur. It's a long way to hell, I ain't really trying to lead this earth. I've come to the conclusion, you can kill me if I kill you first.
Oh my god.
I'm trying to put a diamond ring on her finger. She love drama, she be watching Jerry Springer. Next thing you know, we all on Jerry Springer.
Oh my gosh. She love drama, she watched Jerry Springer. Hey, Jerry Springer was lit. I remember watching that every time I got home from school.
Love games, but no, I'm not a cheater. She hated when I sip codeine, I'm a leaner. Love don't end good for me.
So I don't know if this is like the next girl or something. I don't even know if these have all been different girls. Like, I feel like the theme is like one girl. This revolves around one girl. But I don't know if these, like, each ones is like different relationships. But he says in this song again that she don't like it when I'm on the drugs or whatever. Bro, I don't think anybody's gonna like you probably like a whole different person. And plus, seeing people on drugs, like strung out on drugs, is not, you don't wanna see that. Or fucking drunk all the time, like, that's just not attractive. No. To me, in my opinion.
Don't pray for me, just give me drugs.
Stop, man. This is a no. Go outside. Look at the trees, look at the clouds, bruh. These are some nice ass clouds.
Baby, you jump first. It's a long way to hell, I ain't really trying to lead this earth. Baby, do you?
So you're not trying to go to, I guess he fears that he's gonna go to hell. But at the same time, he said that he doesn't want to leave this earth. But at the same time, this man's doing all these drugs and he knows it's bad for him, but he keeps doing it. Oh my gosh, this is a good ass album, bruh.
My ex bitch too bad, my next bitch way hotter. We met in a car crash, she riding like full throttle.
I'm assuming in this song he's talking about like the girl that he's with now or was with now before, you know, that last who I hear talking about, yeah, I fuck with him. The fuck? Pass me another drink, bitch. So I'm assuming this is just, he's just venting to her or something. Scared of love. We can tell, bruh. You're not scared of drugs, though.
Not scared to love, just scared of love. Not enough, I'm not enough.
He's not scared to love, he's just scared of love. It's a good way to put it.
Put my heart in the grave, I get no love. I need more drugs. All I ever do is get fucked up.
Yeah, we can tell.
Every day I wonder if I can put my heart out my chest. Lately, I'm running out of Zandra.
he really puts you in his mindset with these songs, with his how he's with each one of these songs, he explains his mindset very well. So far in every single track, he has mentioned drugs and his need for it. Jesus Christ. Okay, this next one is called Used To. Used To. I used to love, but I still do drugs.
I've been drinking and driving to survive it. Take my sorrow and bury me alive in
it. My nigga does not want to live. He does not care about his life. Okay, look, if you don't care about your life, by all means, that's you. Do you. But nigga, now you are involving the lives of others. I really liked Juice WRLD, but this man's gotta chill, bruh. I know he's hurt and deep in the dumps, but drinking and driving, bruh, that's a big fat L for you, bruh. That is a big fat L, bruh. I'm not rocking with that.
Crash the car again, goddamn. I don't have no friends, goddamn. I'm alone until the end, goddamn.
Bro, because you freaking drinking and driving, and then you don't got all these friends because you're always on damn drugs, bro. You don't ever want to go outside and do anything, bro. Oh, my, bro. This man, I'm slowly not liking him, bro. Not his music, because I really love his music. His music is amazing. But as a person, I don't think I would want to meet him. I don't think I would want to meet him. Like, I feel like I like his music so much that I wouldn't even know what to say if I was to meet him. I would hope somebody talks to him. Somebody needs to talk to him. If I ever did meet him, or if I ever did had a chance to talk to him, I'd be like, bro, you need. I don't know. But drinking and driving, that's an automatic L. I would tell you that. I'd be like, look, you cannot give a fuck about your life, but for you to drink and drive is stupid. And yeah, that was a good song. All these songs have just great melodies, and I'm just so relaxed listening to it. But it's just like, if you're not listening to the words, oh my gosh, once you start listening to the words, you're like, oh my, this man needs some help, bro. He really needs, like, literally he needs some help. The next one is Karma. It's a skit again, and I can't wait to hear what this girl is talking about this time, bro. I swear. Hopefully, I think this is the final skit. This is the last skit, so I'm very interested to see what happens here.
I called you like a billion times. Why can't you answer the phone? Like, none of that meant nothing to me. He didn't mean anything to me. I told you I was there for you. You just gonna give me all away like that?
But you, oh,
my God. You was just calling me.
I don't care. I love you. I always love you.
I wouldn't be calling you if I didn't love you. I love
L.
you.
L.
None of that bag don't mean shit to me. I don't give a fuck about what you got. I really love you.
She was ducking you all that, saying that she wasn't gonna be nothing. And then my nigga glows up. She was on YouTube having to stumble across a Cole Bennett video. And seen my nigga Juice WRLD and was like, he meant nothing to me. But she was just on the phone talking about some, yeah, and, oh, so you mad now. Bruh, these next five songs, just from this skit alone, I know he about to go in, bruh. You're a bitch and da-da-da. Next song is called Hurt Me.
Crash my whip off the drugs I'm swerving. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but the drugs won't hurt me.
Yes, they will.
Girlfriend keeps calling my phone, but the bitch can't hurt me, so I'm not worried. Smoke my dope and I pop my perky and lock my phone, cause these hoes be lurking.
This man is... Somebody take the keys from this man, alright? If you don't get yourself an Uber, my nigga, it's not that hard. The next song is called Black and White. That girl probably feeling really stupid. All her girlfriends probably around her like, ain't that the one you used to go with?
I'm in my black Benz, doing cocaine with my black friends.
I'm not even surprised. I'm not even surprised. I'm a little bit surprised. I thought, you know, of all the drugs that he was doing, the Xans, you know, the shrooms, you know, these are drugs, you know, sadly, but they are the drugs that, you know, all the kids are doing. They're all the kids are doing it. But this man is now also doing cocaine, bruh. I definitely don't want to meet this dude in person. I love his music, and I really, really wish the best for him because he's very talented. But cocaine, my guy. Cocaine, my guy. Xans, okay? Everybody doing Xans. You could have been just following a trend. Lean trend. Shrooms, you know, that's a trend, I guess. People still do that shit. But cocaine? I thought that shit stopped being cool. I thought niggas stopped doing that, bruh. I thought that we wasn't doing that. I thought that's where we drew the line. Is there a line anymore? Fucking cocaine, bruh.
Doing codeine with my white friends. We'll be high as hell before the... we'll be high before the ends. We'll be high pins. Doing cocaine with my black friends.
I was about to say, I probably heard wrong because he said codeine on the other one, but no, he definitely said cocaine. Okay, let's keep going.
I know that this pack's finna hurt me. Sometimes I feel like they doing surgery. Tell me how they working. I party too damn much. And you niggas can't keep up. Pills with the Hennessy, I might throw up.
Gosh, I feel like this man's gonna be great. He's destined for greatness, but he's just doing all these drugs. And honestly, if we gonna keep it a buck, a lot of these artists that we really, really like that are really making amazing music, these niggas probably do all types of drugs. All types of drugs. If we're keeping it a buck, bruh. This man is one of those people.
Before the night be.
The next song is called Long Gone.
Leave her in the past, but I know I'll miss her. I kept all of her paraphernalia. Think about the days when I used to undress her.
Never think about her again, bro. This is what's making you mad. You just gotta forget this girl, bro. After this album, burn all of that shit, man.
Oh, ho, see that I'm on, so they text me. Ex bitch trying to finesse me. She won't get a damn thing.
Good job, bro. As long as you got your head straight on that one thing, bruh.
Heartbreak mixed with the drugs, not the best thing.
That's what this whole album is, bruh. Heartbreak mixed with drugs. That's what this whole album is. That's what the album should have been called. Heartbreak mixed with drugs.
Wanted you bad,
a year ago.
So bad, but that's long gone, long gone, long gone.
He's done with you now. This man went from calling your phone every night to dodging you, ducking you.
You really had me feeling helpless, that's so selfish.
Bitch. I know how that feeling is though, cause it's like, after you've been through something like that, like, imagine dealing with that shit multiple times. You just start thinking like, bruh, like, is this even gonna last? Like, what is the point? What if it just ends up like every other relationship I was in, bruh? So I understand from that point, that viewpoint, but eventually, you just gotta be like, hey man, I'm going with it, man. I can't control whatever happens. You just gotta go with it, bruh. Just let your heart be free, bruh. You can't just keep holding that shit in, bruh.
I hope this ain't a phase. One more heartbreak and I'll be long gone.
Oh shit, one heartbreak away and I'll be long gone. I don't know who he talking to now, but she got a lot of pressure, okay? She got a lot of pressure on her. I know, bruh, damn. If this man gets really, really famous, how I think he is, like, this man's gonna really be a legend, like... Whoever he is with, if she leaves or does some dumb shit, some hoe shit, bruh, she is going to get dragged, bruh. If this man finds out and he offs himself, she is going to get dragged to no end. Like, oh my gosh, this man is already hurt. She has a lot. LeBron, all she had to do is just be how you're supposed to be in a relationship. It's really not that hard.
I kept all of her paraphernalia. Left her makeup and her panties on my bedroom dresser.
All I'm gonna say is your current girlfriend might not like that too much. I'm just saying that. She might have to get on you for that, bro. And that's well deserved. Don't act like it ain't. Alright. The next song is called End of the Road.
It's suicidal, she wrote. This is the end of her show. It's over. We doing drugs till we in a coma.
R.I.P. to Lil Peep. And I feel like this is what's gonna happen to Juice WRLD. I feel like the same thing's gonna happen to Juice WRLD. Cause this man is mixing shit. He's doing all this, he's drinking and driving. He don't care, he said it on record.
This is as far as it goes. This the end of the road. This the end of the road.
This man is still alive, right? That was End of the Road, which seems like it's alluding to something that I hope it isn't. I hope it's just the song. I feel like he's gonna wanna go out like that. I feel like he wants to go out like, how old is he? I feel like he's trying to join, you know, the club. The last and final song off of this amazing album is Goodbye and Good Riddance. All right, well, that's the name of the album, Goodbye and Good Riddance, but. It's called I'll Be Fine.
I just popped a bean yesterday, it was a long night. I didn't get the right drugs.
It's official. Every song on this album is him doing drugs.
My mama told me stop the painkillers, them shits is killing me.
Listen to your mama. Mama knows best.
I'm dreaming and feigning for more.
That was Juice WRLD's album, Goodbye and Good Riddance. This is all to that girl in the red dress right there in that picture. The girl in the red dress, and as he flicks the finger while he drives away. Like I said, man, this was a good album. I really liked it. It's just, bruh, he's so hurt and he's so strung out on drugs. It's literally in every song. That's how much he does them. It's in every song. And he keeps talking about how he's drinking and driving, or he's swerving and he's on drugs in a car, and how he keeps crashing his cars. But apparently he has someone new, I think. I think so. Apparently he has someone new, and hopefully she treats him not like the last girl. But RIP to this last, once the internet finds out her at, oh geez, oh wow. Did you hear Goodbye and Good Riddance yet? It's about you, you might wanna check it out. But yeah, y'all let me know what y'all think down in the comments below. I hope Juice WRLD gets better. I really like his music and his melodies, more his melodies. But hey, he's got a message. He really had me here like, in my feelings, like, bro, I feel you, bro. First I was confused and now I'm with you. But you gotta cut these drugs out because I'm not with you on that aspect. But y'all let me know what y'all think down in the comments below. If you didn't enjoy my reaction, my commentary, hit that thumbs up. I will catch y'all in the next one.